Hello students, today we are going to study about the Mendel's law. So up till now you know that on which different bases and how Mendel has chosen P plan for his experiment. So now let us see that what are the different laws which Mendel has given. So Mendel's law are dependent on two different factors, two different types of cross. One is monohybrid and the other one is dihybrid cross. Okay, so let's see on the basis of these two, which are the three different laws given by Mendel. So the first law is law of dominance. Second law is law of segregation, and the third law is law of independent assortment. So out of these three laws, these two laws, law of dominance and law of segregation, are based on monohybrid cross, and the third one, law of independent assortment, is based on the dihybrid cross. So Mendel has actually given different factors, and his study was based on the different factors. Now what are these factors? Factors are actually the genes which we call nowadays. Okay, so Mendel has given different factors. For example, he has given two capital T names as are tall. So when a plant is tall, it is represented by capital T and capital T. Small t and small t represents the dwarf plant. Same way, one capital T and one small t also represents the tall plant. There is not intermediate relation in between, means there is no plant that which can be in the height of medium, not even tall, not even dwarf. It will be in intermediate position. It is not going to happen. Always either plant will be tall or it will be dwarf. Okay, now let us see. In law of dominance, Mendel said that always from either of the gametes or from either of the alleles, only one is going to be the dominating one, and the other one which is there, for example in this one, plant is going to be tall, and here this capital T is going to be dominating, and the other one which is this small t, this is the allele of dwarf, right? This one is going to mask itself, means it will hide itself. It is not like that. In this tall plant, there is no allele of dwarf. It is there, it is present there. But the thing is, dominating nature of tall has hidden this dwarf T character. Okay? So this is your law of dominance, where any one single allele is going to dominate the other one. Let us see this with one of the example. Mendel did his experiment on the pure breeds of tall plant. Okay, which is represented by capital T and capital T, and he has taken one dwarf plant which was also pure line. This is small t and small t. When he did cross in between them, then in the F1 generation, which is called as felin 1, okay? So as generations move down, this will be called as F1, F2, F3, F4, right? Like that. So in this first felin 1, first generation, he found that all the plants are tall, but he was not aware that in all these tall plants there is a hidden character or hidden mast allele, which is the small t. Okay, so he got all the tall plants. So further he crossed, he did selfing in those tall plants, and then in F2 generation he found that some trees are tall and some are dwarf. So when he did further study, he found that there is a two gamete. There are actually two gametes, one capital T and one small t, and out of these two, one is dominating itself and the other one is doing recessive. So when you will find the result of this, if you will make a Punnett square for the F2 generation, then you are going to write here small t, here capital T, and you will find this kind of result. Further, if you will do F2, then you are going to do crossing in this F2 generation by selfing them, and you will put this over here like that. Okay, because the output is this, though the plants are tall, but inside they are having this character. So here you will find 2TT means one complete tall plant. Again here, this will be like this, and here it will be like this. So here what you're going to see again, one is pure breed of tall and two are here which are tall, but inside there is a hidden character of the dwarf pea plant, and this one is pure dwarf. Okay, so let us see how you're going to write the result of this. There are two types of ratios in our output. One is called phenotypic and the other one is called genotypic. Phenotypic ratio and genotypic ratio. Phenotypic ratio means whatever externally is visible, on that basis whatever ratio you take out, that is called phenotypic ratio. So externally in this F2 generation you are watching that 1, 2 and 3, these 3 are tall and 1 is dwarf, right? So we will write here 3:1. But if you will see genotypically, means inside according to the genes, if you are going to see, you will see 1 is pure tall. So we will write here 1:2, and 2 are here which are having both the gametes, tall and dwarfs, right? So you're going to write 2:2 and 1 is completely dwarf, right? So you're going to write here 1. So this is your result going to be for the law of dominance. This same cross you make for law of segregation also. But as name itself tells you that segregation means segregate or to divide, to differentiate, right? So what is done in the law of segregation? Law of segregation says that in this, though both the gametes, both the alleles are present, allele of tall and allele of dwarf, both are present, it is not going to show any intermediate character. It will be always either tall or it will be dwarf. There is no mixture, no blending. So for law of segregation, a word is used, you can always write that it shows no blending. Blending means mixture. So it is never going to show any kind of a mixture. It will be always pure form. So it is also called as pure law of purity. Okay. So today we have studied law of dominance and law of segregation. So keep this in your mind. You can see this old work and recall all the things what we have studied today in this video.